Hello, my name is Timmy Time, and this is my fanfic reading. It, to be honest, it kind of sounds like an ASMR, but it's not. Because I'm doing like fucking noises. Anyways, Naomi the Parrot, I think that's her name. I'll leave her email down below. Actually, sent me this request in as to read it, and like she actually asked me, "Do Yossi's count?" I'm like, "Sure." I said yes. And I guess I'm gonna read her bio. Okay, Naomi the Parrot. I need to do this for Columbus. Name Naomi. Name meaning Naomi means heavenly mist. Ooh. Gender female. Race, she's a parrot, a lovely parrot. I'm sure she is. I wish I could meet her. Okay. Here it is. Homeworld, in the tropical forest, which happens to be around Oscar's Zomobius, she doesn't know that. Oh, just, I'm guessing she lives far, but okay. Occupation, she's a tribeswoman. She usually hunts fish for her tribe, since she really can't do much else. Birthday? Sorry, I forget what month was that, but man, I really suck at months. Oh, it's February 4th, 2001. She's my age? Uh-huh. Oh, no. Yeah, she's my age. She was born a year earlier. Okay. So, Dixon, she was born near the beginning of April. What? It just said her birthday was... never mind. I don't even know. Okay. It's Aries. She has average height of 5.4 inches. She's pretty lightweight enough. Her weight is 83 pounds. Her skin is red, just like your feathers. Eye color, she has a... Sure, her eyes are lime green with black pupils. And looks like she has some scales. Yes, in fact, she has it on the wings of her. So yeah, scales basically everywhere. And up, while I'm reading this, I'm gonna pull up the design of her so you guys can see how old she is. And I'm gonna show you who drew it and everything else, and maybe I'll leave. Okay, who she likes? She likes helping her tribe by gaining food for them. The best she can really gain for them is through its fish. She acts a bit like a seagull and dips her head in the water. Then keeps the fish in her beak until she returns to her tribe. She also happens to like making clay sculptures. She goes to her familiar tree staple stump and just creates anything that pops into her mind and inspires her. She also enjoys doing it is flying about the forest that she resides in. It allows her to eavesdrop on other people's conversations undetected. Well, unless she misses them and flies straight into the trees and cuts a ruckus. It happens quite often, I should say. She loves changing her appearance often as well. She isn't even a fantasia. She a fashion tia. I don't know how to spell it. I'm sorry if I said that wrong. She wants to find a unique way to make herself different. She doesn't want to change drastically though. She just doesn't want her to think she's just an intruder or sorts, because she looked like completely different. Oh, her dislikes. Now look out for you guys. See if you guys remember. Okay. She hates the fact that she doesn't have any friends, because that's pretty much talking to people, excluding the track. She also somewhat dislikes the fact that she will have to fight people on occasion. She doesn't like that, because she hates violence, because it could lead to severe injuries or even death. That's true. Of course, she will fight if she had to, but that hardly happens, since, well, she put a few rules for herself for when she fight, when she should flee, or when she attempt to talk it out. Another sad thing is that she has attempted to stutter. The only thing, because the fact that she's so shy and used to communicate with other humans, being excluded from tribe members. I don't think they're humans, more like Mobians, I guess. Okay, there's another thing that Holy, what's that? Oh, wait. It's people who have no personality or are generally perfect in every single way. She has done 3 types of movies that make her someone because she's basically friendless. It means she doesn't like her. Well, she hasn't actually gotten into a fight before, but she has trained with a dummy, so she had basic fighting skills, so she can tell with people who are similar fighting stats as her or below agility capability. It's only okay. The only power is power. The only quote on powers. Well, she really has to fight. It's only because. Sorry about that ring thing you guys heard. No, I'll go turn it off. Okay. She's highly capable of setting up traps. She has done it before with animals. So she just really can really. Really she never really captures. And they just still work. But the only she has a try was people. She just hardly uses it. She hates violence. Well, it seems like she has a theme, and I'm not sure if I can play them, but I'll leave the links below. Now her backstory. I want to be as good as I can. But backs off. I'm guessing she's really stuttering. Long ago, 2 tribes ruled over Mobius Forest. Hiatus and Columbus. One day, Columbus had a small disagreement with Hiatus. I don't know if Hiatus. That was how Hiatus. It was very minor at first. Then, only until Zelius, both tribes started to flat out despise each other. No one knew how, and no one knew why. It just happened. But when that did, the feud became so about a war occurred. Zelius flat out forced their tribes to attack each other. Hiatus and Columbus fought hard just to protect their tribes and family. After 2 entire months of fighting, Hiatus eventually won, making tribes people that were left alive and Columbus go into hiding. Hiatus conquered most of the forest as Columbus was growing in danger. The people of Columbus didn't know how to live without a leader. A few years later, a paper fell from the sky. It was supposed to be dropped off to their mother and father, but the stork carrying the prayer got hit by a storm, so the young youth was trapped. Coincidentally, it landed in the forest where the war took place years ago. That shriek could be heard from children as laid alone in the forest, alone and hungry. Then, someone found the young parrot. It appeared to be a male, and it seemed to belong to a tribe of some sort. He picked up the parrot and took it back to where he lived. While explaining the parts of the forest, he knew the baby would understand what he was saying, but continued. Sorry? And continued Elabort, nonetheless. When he returned with the baby, a bunch of people would look directly at the baby. The tribe was full of different species, hedgehogs, cats, crocodiles, you name it. Instead of attacking the baby on the spot, they took it in, hoping they would be able to help them in the near future. Later find out the baby was a female. They didn't know what to call her since they had a boy name planned. But not girl names, so the people that found her let it come naturally. The child never received her name until she was 5 years old. It happened one time when one tribe sat down beside her, delivering a small breeze process. A child's small wings would sway somewhat as the wind blew through her face. That was when it hit them. The name of the child, Naomi, Heavenly Mist. He told the tribe what he thought of, and they all instantly agreed, despite not being there to witness his reasoning. And the tribe's person walked to Naomi and said, "Naomi, welcome to Columbus, Naomi." And that's, it seems like that's it. Now, I will include the picture she has of him, the links below, and I hope you enjoyed it. And not only if you're watching this right now, I hope you enjoyed me reading your backstory. Now, see ya.